Yesterday, we began a study of God's plan for unity. And in this lesson yesterday, we looked at the fact that unity cannot be created artificially because it is not man's to create. Today, we're going to pick up our lesson in Psalm 133 and verse 1, which says, "Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity." Unity is God's fervent desire for His children, and the forces of God cannot battle the forces of Satan if they're too busy fighting with each other. Jesus said that every city or house that is divided against itself will not stand, Matthew 12 and verse 25. Now going into our lesson for today, we see that the second part of God's plan for unity is that unity requires submission to God. The unity plan of man is flawed at its very core. This concept of unity in diversity seeks unity among people by attempting to get them to dispense with their differences so that they can be at peace. Well, this is not actually peace. This artificial environment suppresses emotions and feelings while two parties are together. The passion still remains, but they're hidden behind artificial smiles and handshakes. But God's plan says that we submit ourselves to Christ and we become united, Ephesians 4 verses 15 and 16. Unity and diversity unites men and then presents them to God for acceptance. Man's plan makes man proactive and God passive. Instead, God is the creator and sustainer of unity, and any plan that empowers man over God should instantly be discarded. When we practice unity and diversity, we look to each other and try to reconcile our views when in actuality, we should all be looking at God and reconciling ourselves to Him. Imagine this. Imagine that Christ is on a path headed toward heaven. His disciples are following behind Him. And when all of His disciples are focused solely on Him and on His teachings and bringing glory to Him, they're united. Friends, this is the only way that biblical unity can ever occur. Biblical unity centered in Christ and in His Word means that we unite around something that is perfect. To unite around something imperfect, like diversity, means that we're doomed to fail. But the source of our unity must be perfect and indestructible so that it withstands the rigors of changing cultures and standards. Otherwise, the source of our unity will be fluid and the group will constantly be shifting around the ebbs and flows of different ideas and doctrines. But unity must be accomplished according to Christ's rules, since He is the absolute head of the church. We are all to be focused upon Him. The orchestra is a perfect example. Imagine if all the members of an orchestra selected their own instruments, music, volume, and pace, regardless of what anyone else in the group was doing. It would sound awful, and the audience would make a very hasty exit from that place. But instead, the conductor selects the music, the volume, and the pace. He leads and directs everyone. They follow Him, or they will be removed from the group. When the conductor takes charge and the members comply, it's a beautiful thing to behold. The audience will be edified and eager to return, and everyone in the group is focused on the success of the whole and not simply on themselves and getting their own way. Well, friends, God's plan for unity is simple and takes the responsibility of construction and organization away from man. Well, since He has already created and organized it, we simply enter into it and comply with it. And this is a wonderful plan because it means that no humans will be in charge, and therefore there will be fewer hurt feelings and points of contention. Now, man is searching for unity everywhere, when it's actually right in front of him. Yet he fails to accept it because he will have no control over it. So often, man's stubbornness will have to be subordinate to God's will. Pride is continually man's destruction, and Satan has nurtured that at every single turn. It likewise fails us in the unity that so many claim to desire. Thank you for joining us for our program today. Please consider these things and have a blessed day.